The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Happy welcome, my dear students. We are dealing with the third chapter, that is motion in a straight line, and we got introduced concepts like speed, velocity and its average and instantaneous value. Now it's time to introduce another concept, that is acceleration. So what is acceleration? Acceleration, or what do you mean by accelerate? Accelerate means to increase. Okay, accelerate ennu parayna word inde meaning to increase ennalladana. So what is acceleration? Yes, acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with time. Rate of change of velocity with time. Imagine an object which is moving with a particular velocity. Okay, after some time, if the object changes its velocity, okay, and this change in velocity with time is known as acceleration. So acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with time, or acceleration describes how fast an object is moving with time. Okay, how fast an object is moving with time, or how fast an object is changing its velocity with time. This is known as acceleration. So in the previous class, we learned velocity, or we have defined velocity, right? And velocity is the rate of change of position with time. Alle, or object in the position time in anusarichu maarunnathinaanu nammude velocity ennu parne define cheyathu. Adhe pole or object in the velocity time in anusarichu maarunnathine, allekil this rate of change of velocity with time is known as acceleration. And what about this acceleration? Is it a scalar quantity or vector quantity? Yes, acceleration is a vector quantity. So acceleration is a vector quantity. Why? Because acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with time, and this velocity, it is a vector quantity. This velocity is having both the magnitude and the direction. Appo velocity illulla change niyana acceleration ennu parayunnathu. Ee velocity oru vector aanu, adagonde thanne accelerationum endanu oru vector aanu. So listen, my dear students, change of velocity with time. Appo velocity illulla change ennu parayumbo, velocity oru vector quantity aanu ennu parnu kaniyal velocity ku oru magnitude undu, direction undu. So acceleration is the change of velocity with time. Appo velocity illulla change ennu parnu kaniyal velocity ennu parayunnathu oru vector quantity aanu, velocity ku magnitude undu, direction undu. Appo velocity illulla change ennu parnu kaniyal adu velocity de magnitude illulla change aavam, allengil velocity de direction illulla change aavam. Appo velocity de magnitude ne aanu nammal speed ennu vilikkunnathu. Okay, so nammal parayullo velocity is equal to 10 meter per second. So that is the magnitude of velocity. അതിനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ സ്പീഡ് എന്ന് വിളിക്കുന്നത്. വെലോസിറ്റിയുടെ മാഗ്നിറ്റ്യൂഡിനെയാണ് സ്പീഡ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. അപ്പൊ സ്പീഡിൽ ചേഞ്ച് വരികയാണെങ്കിൽ, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വെലോസിറ്റിയുടെ ഡയറക്ഷനിൽ ചേഞ്ച് വരികയാണെങ്കിലും, അവിടെ എന്തുണ്ടാവും? ആക്സിലറേഷൻ മേ ടേക്സ് പ്ലേസ്. ക്ലിയർ? സോ ആക്സിലറേഷൻ ഇസ് ദ റേറ്റ് ഓഫ് ചേഞ്ച് ഓഫ് വെലോസിറ്റി വിത്ത് ടൈം, ആൻഡ് ദിസ് ആക്സിലറേഷൻ ഇസ് എ വെക്ടർ quantity. Why? Because it is the change of velocity, and this velocity is a vector quantity. Clear? And what about the unit of acceleration? Yes, the unit of acceleration is meter per second square. So this is the unit of acceleration. Now listen, children, now let's define average acceleration. The average acceleration a bar, average acceleration is denoted by a bar. So the average acceleration a bar over a time interval is defined as the change of velocity divided by the time interval. That means A bar is equal to change of velocity divided by the time interval. So that is V2 minus V1 divided by T2 minus T1, where V2 minus V1 is the change in velocity, which is represented by delta V, and T2 minus T1 is the change in time, right? And it is denoted by delta T. So average acceleration A bar is equal to delta V divided by delta T. Okay, so let me compare this expression with the expression of average velocity. As it was, V bar is equal to x2 minus x1 divided by T2 minus T1, or that is equal to delta x divided by delta t, that is the change in position with time, that is known as velocity. Okay, x2 minus x1 nu parayunnathu position lulla change aanu, t2 minus t1 nu parayunnathu time lulla change aanu alle. So delta x by delta t aanu velocity ennu parayunnathu, or the average velocity v bar is equal to delta x by delta t. In the same manner, average acceleration a bar is equal to delta v by delta t. So position time anusarichu change cheynathaanu velocity, velocity time anusarichu change cheynathaanu acceleration. Clear? So in the previous class we have discussed this concept, that is the physical significance of a position time graph. Adayithu oru position time graph inde slope aanu velocity ennu parayunnathu, allengil oru object inde position time graph varikkayanengil adinte slope kandupidikkayanengil aa object inde velocity ethrayanennu namukku parayanayittu pattum. Adhe pole oru object ine velocity time graph varikkayanengil aa velocity time graph il ninnum avadathe slope kandupidikkayanengil, which will give you the acceleration of the object. Clear? So that is the physical significance of velocity time graph. So this is average acceleration. Average acceleration a bar is equal to v2 minus v1 by t2 minus t1, and that is equal to delta v by delta t. Appo t1 time ilulla instantaneous velocity aanu v1, t2 time ilulla instantaneous velocity aanu v2. So ee velocity galude time anusarichulla change neyanu nammal acceleration. So acceleration indicates, or acceleration describes, how fast an object is changing its velocity with time. Yes, now let's discuss the instantaneous acceleration. So instantaneous acceleration is defined in the same way as the instantaneous velocity. Okay, instantaneous acceleration is defined in the same way as the instantaneous velocity. So acceleration at an instant, that is instantaneous acceleration. So listen children, let me recall the expression for instantaneous velocity first. Instantaneous velocity v is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta x by delta t. Okay, where delta x by delta t is the average velocity and instantaneous velocity v is the limit of average velocity when the time interval delta t approaches 0, or when the time interval becomes infinitely small. Okay, appo ivadathe in time interval valare small aavuna oru samayathu allengil approaches to 0, 0 ilike approach cheyina samayathulla average velocity de limit, that is known as instantaneous velocity. In the same manner, we can define the instantaneous acceleration, that is instantaneous acceleration a is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta v by delta t, where delta v by delta t is the average acceleration. So instantaneous acceleration is the limit of average acceleration when delta t becomes infinitely small, or delta t approaches to 0. Okay, appo instantaneous acceleration nu parayunnathu average acceleration. This is the expression for average acceleration, right? Just now we have discussed. So delta v by delta t is the average acceleration. So the limit of average acceleration as the time interval delta t becomes infinitely small, or as the time interval approaches to zero, is called instantaneous acceleration. Okay, so the instantaneous acceleration is the acceleration at an instant. And one more thing, instantaneous acceleration or the acceleration at an instant is the slope of the tangent to the vt curve. Vt curve nu parayanengil velocity time graph namukku varachu kaniyal avade kittuna curve. Okay, see, for example, time നമ്മൾ x ആക്സിസിലും velocity y ആക്സിസിലും പ്ലോട്ട് ചെയ്തിട്ട് നമ്മൾ ഒരു ഗ്രാഫ് വരയ്ക്കുകയാണെന്ന് ഇമാജിൻ ചെയ്യുക. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ വി ടി കർവ്. ഈ വി ടി കർവില് ഒരു ഇൻസ്റ്റന്റില് സപ്പോസ് ടി വൺ എന്ന് കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ടി വൺ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ടൈമിന് കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഈ ഒരു ഇൻസ്റ്റന്റിൽ നമ്മൾ ഇവിടുത്തെ കർവിന്റെ സ്ലോപ്പ് കണ്ടുപിടിക്കുകയാണ്. സ്ലോപ്പ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഇൻ ദിസ് മാനർ. Okay, so that slope of the tangent to this curve, actually this is the tangent and the slope of this tangent to this vt curve, and this is the instantaneous acceleration. Appo t1 ennu parayna time ine corresponding aayittulla ivadte velocity time graph inde allekil vt curve inde slope nammal kandupidichu. So ee instant ile acceleration ennu parayunnathu ivadte ee tangent inde slope aanu. Okay, so the acceleration at an instant is the slope of the tangent to the vt curve. Okay, appo velocity time graph nammal ingane varakkiyanengil ee velocity time graph inde slope niyana acceleration ennu parayunnathu. Appo idine corresponding aayittla acceleration time graph varakkan parnal enginiyana varikkendathu. Yes, the acceleration time graph will be, the corresponding acceleration time graph will be like this, because acceleration, it is the slope of velocity time graph, so the graph will be like this. Clear? So we know that acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with time, so we can write an expression for acceleration in differential form, that is a is equal to dv divided by dt. Okay, appo limit delta t tends to 0 delta v by delta t ne namukku replace edittu differential form il engane ezhudam, a is equal to dv by dt. So this indicates that the acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with time. Okay, the change in velocity with respect to time, that is acceleration. Appo instantaneous velocity define cheyda samayathu nammal avade ezhudirunnu v is equal to dx by dt. Appo avade position with respect to time namukku differentiate cheythal velocity kittum, right? Velocity is equal to dx by dt. ഓക്കെ, അതായത് ഒരു ഒബ്ജക്റ്റിന്റെ പൊസിഷനെ വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു ടൈം ഡിഫറൻഷ്യേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ വെലോസിറ്റി കിട്ടും. അതേപോലെ ഒരു ഒബ്ജക്റ്റിന്റെ വെലോസിറ്റിനെ വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു ടൈം ഡിഫറൻഷ്യേറ്റ് ചെയ്താൽ നമുക്ക് ആക്സിലറേഷൻ കിട്ടും. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദി ഡിഫറൻഷ്യൽ ഫോം ഓഫ് ആക്സിലറേഷൻ, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു ഡി വി ബൈ ഡി ടി. Listen children, like velocity, acceleration can also be positive, negative or zero. Okay, so here we can see the position time graph for motion with positive acceleration, negative acceleration as well as zero acceleration. Okay, appo or object positive acceleration la move aanengil endana position time graph varya. Yes, the position time graph for an object moving with positive acceleration will be like this. Okay, ingane oru curve irikkum varya. And for an object which is moving with negative acceleration, the corresponding position time graph will be like this. And for an object with zero acceleration, the corresponding position time graph will be like this. Okay, appo moonu vyathyastha acceleration la move in the object idalude position time graph galaanu ivide varachirikkunnathu. അപ്പോൾ ഇതിന്റെ കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് വെലോസിറ്റി ടൈം ഗ്രാഫുകൾ എങ്ങനെയായിരിക്കും വരിക? സോ ഇറ്റ്സ് എ ഹോംവർക്ക് ഫോർ യു, ട്രൈ ടു ഡ്രോ ദ കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് വെലോസിറ്റി ടൈം ഗ്രാഫ്സ്. അതായത് പോസിറ്റീവ് ആക്സിലറേഷന് കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് ആയി, നെഗറ്റീവ് ആക്സിലറേഷന് കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് ആയിട്ടും, സീറോ ആക്സിലറേഷന് കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് ആയിട്ടും വെലോസിറ്റി ടൈം ഗ്രാഫുകൾ വരയ്ക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ എങ്ങനെയായിരിക്കും വരിക? സോ ഇറ്റ്സ് എ ഹോംവർക്ക് ഫോർ യു. ആൻഡ് ഹിയർ ഐ വിൽ ഗിവ് യു എ ഹിന്റ്, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് പൊസിഷൻ ടൈം ഗ്രാഫിന്റെ സ്ലോപ്പ് ആയിരിക്കും എന്ത്? വെലോസിറ്റി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. സോ ട്രൈ ടു ഡു ദിസ് ഹോംവർക്ക്. Now listen children, here we are going to discuss an interesting fact. Yes, here we have drawn a vt curve. Okay, ഇവിടെ ഒരു velocity time graph ആണ് വരച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. Okay, അപ്പൊ ഇതാണ് നമ്മുടെ velocity time graph എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് അല്ലെ. ഈ ഒരു സ്ട്രേറ്റ് ലൈൻ ആണ് ഇവിടുത്തെ vt curve എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. അപ്പോ വെലോസിറ്റി ടൈം ഗ്രാഫിന്റെ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വി ടി കർവിന്റെ സ്ലോപ്പ് എന്താണെന്നാ പറഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നത്? യെസ്, ആക്സിലറേഷൻ. അപ്പോ ഇവിടുത്തെ ഈ സ്ട്രെയിറ്റ് ലൈനിന്റെ സ്ലോപ്പ് നമ്മൾ കണ്ടുപിടിക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ വിച്ച് വിൽ ബി ദ ആക്സിലറേഷൻ. ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ദ സ്ലോപ്പ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് സ്ട്രെയിറ്റ് ലൈൻ? യെസ്, നമ്മൾ ഓൾറെഡി ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്തൊരു കാര്യമാണ്, ഇത്തരത്തിൽ എക്സ് ആക്സിസിന് പാരലൽ ആയി വരയ്ക്കുന്ന ഒരു സ്ട്രെയിറ്റ് ലൈനിന്റെ സ്ലോപ്പ് എന്താണ്? സീറോ ആണ്. So in this case, the acceleration A is zero, or the object is moving with constant acceleration. Clear? Okay. Appo VT curve-inte slope nammal kandupidikkanengil, which will give you the acceleration. That is clear. Now let me ask you another question. Listen children, I have shaded this much region. Okay? Ithrayum aga njan shade idu nu imagine cheya. And what about the area under this curve? So ividulla ee vt curve enclose cheyina area aanu ithrayum le. Appo ee area nammal calculate cheyyanengil aa area il ninnu namukku oru physical quantity kittum. And what about that physical quantity? Listen children, if you are finding out the area of this much region, means this is a rectangle, right? You can see this is a rectangle. And what about the area of a rectangle? Is that is length into breadth, right? Here the length is t. Okay, length is t. And what about the breadth? That is u. Suppose this is 0, then this much length, that is t, and this much length, that is u, right? So length into breadth means u into t. U into t means u is initial velocity, or it's a kind of velocity, and t means it's a time. Okay, but velocity into time. What about velocity into time? Yes, for this, recall this expression. The velocity of an object is defined in this way, that is, it is the rate of change of displacement with time, or displacement divided by time of an object is known as velocity. So what is velocity into time? From this expression, we can write d is equal to v into t, right? V into t, velocity into time. So what is velocity into time? Yes, the displacement of an object over a given time interval. So here also, what is u into t? Yes, that is the displacement of an object. So what is u into t? The displacement of an object. So what is the physical significance of VT curve? The slope of the tangent to the VT curve gives you the acceleration. Also, the area under VT curve will give you the displacement of an object over a given time interval. Appo oru VT curve-inte allengil velocity time graph ithrathil enclose cheyina area calculate cheythal, which will be the displacement of an object over a given time interval. And this is the physical significance of VT curve. Hope you understood this. Listen children, now let's derive the kinematic equations in physics. Kinematic equations for uniformly accelerated motion. So let's derive the kinematic equations for uniformly accelerated motion. So what do you mean by kinematic equations? Actually, these are simple equations that relate the displacement, the time taken, the initial velocity v0, the final velocity v, and the acceleration of an object, that is a. Okay, our displacement, time taken, initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, ഇത്രയും ഫിസിക്കൽ ക്വാണ്ടിറ്റീസിനെ തമ്മിൽ റിലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഫിസിക്സിലുള്ള ഇക്വേഷൻസിനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ കൈനമാറ്റിക് ഇക്വേഷൻസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് യു മീൻ ബൈ യൂണിഫോംലി ആക്സിലറേറ്റഡ് മോഷൻ? യൂണിഫോംലി ആക്സിലറേറ്റഡ് മോഷൻ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ മോഷൻ വിത്ത് കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് ആക്സിലറേഷൻ. കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് ആക്സിലറേഷനിൽ മൂവ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒബ്ജക്ട്സിനുള്ള കൈനമാറ്റിക് ഇക്വേഷൻസ് ആണ് നമ്മൾ ഡിറൈവ് ചെയ്യാനായിട്ട് പോകുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, മോഷൻ ഓഫ് ആൻ ഒബ്ജക്ട് വിത്ത് constant acceleration. So constant acceleration le move in object inulla kinematic equations aanu nammal derive cheyanayittu povunathu. So kinematic equations, see for example, this you have learned in your high school classes, that is v is equal to u plus at, right? S is equal to ut plus half at square, and v square is equal to u square plus 2as, right? So these are the kinematic equation. Here v is the final velocity, u is the initial velocity. Appo initial velocity ne u allengil V0 വെച്ച് നമ്മൾ ഡിനോട്ട് ചെയ്യാറുണ്ട് ഒന്നുമില്ലെങ്കിൽ V0 കൊണ്ട് നമുക്ക് ഡിനോട്ട് ചെയ്യാം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സ്മോൾ ലെറ്റർ യു കൊണ്ട് ഇനിഷ്യൽ വെലോസിറ്റിനെ റെപ്രസെന്റ് ചെയ്യാം ഓക്കെ സോ V is equal to U plus AT S is equal to UT plus half AT square and finally V square is equal to U square plus 2AS so these are the kinematic equations so here we are going to derive these kinematic equations so there are actually two methods to derive these kinematic equations the first method is the graphical method that is we are going to derive kinematic equations from graphs so let's discuss yes listen children here is the vt curve for an object moving with constant acceleration or uniform acceleration and we know that the slope of this curve will give the acceleration and the area under this vt curve will give the displacement over a given time interval so here t is the time v0 is the initial velocity and v is the final velocity and from this graph it is clear that ivide bd ennu parayna length v ennu parayna velocity ku corresponding aanu alle appo ivide bd ennu parayna itrayum length v ennu parayna velocity ku corresponding aanu and cd ennu parayna length o v0 ennu parayna velocity ku corresponding aanu so what about this much length adayith bc ennu parayna length ethrayanu varya yes bd ennu paraynathu total v aanu cd ennu paraynathu v0 aanu so bc will be v minus v0 so bc ennu parayna length v minus v0 ennu parayna velocity ku corresponding aayirikkum clear and from this graph actually this is the vt curve alle ab ennu parayunnathaan ivadte vt curve and actually it is a straight line okay appo a straight line inde general equation nammal inginaanu ezhudunnathu that is y is equal to mx plus c this you will learn in mathematics mathematics le idu ningal padikkan povunnunde straight lines nu parayna chapter le appo a straight line inde equation nammal ezhudunnathu y equal to mx plus c ennalladana okay y nu parayunnathu y axis nu varuna distance aanu m nu parayunnathu slope of the curve aanu x nu parayunnatho x axis illa distance and c is the y intercept y intercept means listen children nammude graph y axis il touch cheynade edu point il aanu allekil etra length vareyanu that length is known as c or y intercept clear and in this graph it is v0 okay ivadte y intercept nu parayna endanu itrim distance kaiyittla ee oru point il aanu graph y axis il touch cheynade so here y intercept is v0 okay so from this graph since this curve is a straight line we can write an expression for or we can write an equation for this straight line and it will be instead of y here we have the distance v right so v is equal to mx plus c what is m yes m is the slope of the curve and from this graph from this vt curve what about the slope of vt curve yes that is the acceleration so instead of m we can write a why because the acceleration that is the slope of this curve right appo ivide m nu parayunnathu straight line inde slope ne aanu uddeshikkunnathu and ivadathe slope nu parayunnathu endanu acceleration aanu so a and what about x x axis la varuna distance ethrayanu t aanu alle so t plus what about y intercept yes as I said earlier c is the y intercept and here in this case it is this much distance and that is v0 okay so what about this expression v is equal to v0 plus at allengil namukku v0 ne engane ezhudam u nu venengil ezhudam that is v is equal to u plus at this was the first kinematic equation so here we have derived the first kinematic equation that is v is equal to v0 plus at now listen children in order to derive the second kinematic equation let's consider this that is the area between 0 and t okay 0 to t vare illa area namukku consider cheyam and actually what about this area is from this graph 0 to t nammle area consider cheyanengil actually it is the sum of the area of this rectangle and this triangle so the area between 0 and t is equal to area of triangle abc plus area of the rectangle OACD. Okay, so the area between 0 and T is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of rectangle OACD. Clear? And what about the area of triangle ABC? Yes, ഒരു ട്രയാങ്കിളിന്റെ ഏരിയ നമ്മൾ എങ്ങനെ കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുക? What about the equation? That is half BH, right? Half into base into altitude or height. Right? Here, what about base? Base nu parayunnathu AC aanu, and AC is equal to 0 to T distance ethre varya? T. Appo AC nu parayunna distance ethre aanu? T aanu. And what about H? Height ethre aanu? V minus V0. So half into V minus V0 into T is the area of triangle ABC. And what about the area of rectangle OACD? OACD ennu parayna rectangle de area enda varya? Rectangle de area nu parayunnathu length into breadth aanu. So here the length is T, and what about the breadth? That is V0. Okay, so area between 0 and T, 0 and T kedakkulla area, actually VT curve inde area aanu. Yes, VT curve inde area nammal calculate cheyanengil adil ninnum kittuna physical quantity endayirikkum? Yes, displacement aayirikkum le. So the area between 0 and T nu parneyanal, which will give you the displacement of an object over a given time interval. Appo ivdathe area nu parayunnathu endinod equivalent aanu? Displacement x node equivalent aanu. So nammal thottu munne discuss cheedittulla oru kaaryamaanu, oru VT curve inde area calculate cheyanengil that area will be the displacement of an object over a given time interval. Appo ivdathe area ennu parayunnathu edhu physical quantity yodu equal aanu, allengil LHS il namukku engane ezhuthaam? X, where x is the displacement, and that is equal to the area of triangle ABC, that is half into V minus V0 into T plus area of the rectangle OACD, that is V0 into T from the graph. Now you listen, children. Here we have derived the first kinematic equation, that is V is equal to V0 plus AT, right? And from this, what about V minus V0? Yes, if it is V0 ne nammal LHS like edukkanengil, it will be minus V0. So V minus V0 will be A into T. So here in this expression, instead of this V minus V0, we can substitute AT. So what about this? X is equal to half into, instead of V minus V0, we can substitute AT. So AT into T plus V0T. And that is equal to, X is equal to half AT into T, that is AT square plus V0 into T. Or we can write X is equal to V0T in the term first term. So V0T plus half AT square. Yes, this is the second kinematic equation. Now, you can imagine V0 in U, imagine X in the S and imagine. You can learn that S is equal to UT plus half AT square, or X is equal to V0T plus half AT square. So this is the second kinematic equation. Hope you understood this. Now listen, children, now let's derive the third kinematic equation, that is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. So for this, let's consider an equation, that is in between we have derived an expression like this, that is X is equal to half into V minus V0 into T plus V0T. Okay, now listen, children, let's rewrite this expression. Okay, so for this, let's expand this bracket. So this will be half V into T minus half V0 into T plus V0T. Okay, that is equal to half VT. Now what about minus half V0T plus V0T? For simplicity, let's replace V0T by X. Okay, apo minus half X plus X. And the answer varya minus half X plus X nu varna plus 1X nalladana le. Apo 1 and half boy kaini etre varya? It will be half X. So here it will be half X. Instead of X, here we have V0T. So this will be half VT plus half V0T. So ivide common aayittulla terms edukkiyana? Time um adu pole half nalla number um le. So this will be V plus V0 divided by 2 into T. Why? Because half and T, these two terms are common. Okay, so V plus V0 by 2 into T. So X is equal to V plus V0 by 2 into T. And that is equal to V bar into T. Where V bar is the average velocity and that is equal to V plus V0 by 2. Okay, and this is an expression which is applicable only for constant acceleration. Constant acceleration varuna situation le maatrame namukku itharathil oru relation ezhudanayittu pattullu. That is the average velocity that can be written as the arithmetic mean of initial final velocities of an object, where v is the final velocity and v0 is the initial velocity. Appo initial final velocity galude arithmetic mean aayittu namukku average velocity ne represent cheyanayittu pattu edhu case le constant acceleration varuna situations le. Okay, so here we can replace the term v plus v0 by 2 by the term average velocity. Okay, so we can replace v plus v0 by 2 by the term v bar, where v bar is the average velocity that is equal to v plus v0 by 2. So listen children, we have the expression x is equal to v bar into t, where v bar is the average velocity that is v plus v0 by 2. Okay, now what about time? Yes, here we have derived the first kinematic equation, and from this equation we can write v minus v0 is equal to at, or t is equal to v minus v0 by a. Okay, t is equal to v minus v0 by a. Now let's substitute for v bar and t in this expression. So x is equal to, instead of v bar we have v plus v0 by 2 into, instead of t we have the relation v minus v0 by a, v minus v0 by a. Okay, now listen children, what about v plus v0 into v minus v0? Yes, we have learned this identity, that is a plus b into a minus b, that is equal to a square minus b square. So here instead of a we have v, and instead of b we have v0. So what is a plus b into a minus b? A square minus b square. So what is v plus v0 into v minus v0? V square minus v0 square divided by 2a, 2 into a, 2a. So x is equal to v square minus v0 square by 2a, or v square minus v0 square is equal to, let's multiply these two terms, so it will be 2ax, or v square is equal to minus v0 square ne RHS le kondu varum endavum, yes, plus v0 square plus 2ax. Yes, this is the third kinematic equation. Here instead of v0 we can imagine u, and instead of x we can imagine yes. So what about the expression v square is equal to v0 square plus 2ax, allengil u square plus 2as. Clear? So this is the third kinematic equation. So listen children, by graphical method we have derived the three kinematic equations. That is, the first one is v is equal to v0 plus at. The second one is x is equal to v0t plus half at square. And the third one is v square is equal to v0 square plus 2ax. So hope you understood this derivation. So my dear children, that's all for today. In the coming class, we can derive the kinematic equation by the second method, that is by using the method of calculus, that we can do in the next class. So hope you understood today's class. See you in the next session. Until we meet in the next session, it's a bye from me, Kirti teacher.